Morning, WHB. I'm Ellen.
And I'm Morgan.
And welcome back to the Hurricane Watch.
It was really hard coming back after winter break, but I think we have Monday off.
Of course you do. It's Martin Luther King Day.
Period 7 found out the true purpose of our day off.
Dr. Martin Luther King was a respected leader who practiced civil disobedience in the civil rights movement from the mid-50s until his death in 1968.
We went around West Hampton Beach to find out what the students and staff knew about Dr. King.
I'm here with Kara. Where did Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. send his famous letter from?
A Birmingham jail.
Correct. What year was Martin Luther King born?
Oh, I'm going to say either 1930 or 1929.
1929 is correct. Do you know what year Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. delivered his I Have a Dream?
1969.
Incorrect. 1963.
Because I have a dream.
As we have this Monday off, take a moment to reflect on the advancements in the civil rights movement Dr. King was responsible for.
What a great reminder of why we honor Martin Luther King Day. Morgan.
Sorry, I could never put this down.
Me neither. Miller, Abby, and Delaney put their social media addictions to the test in a phone detox. Let's check it out.
Last week, Delaney, Abby, and Miller all deleted their social medias for 3 days. Let's see how they're doing.
2 hours and 22 minutes average.
I have 7 hours and 5 minute average.
5 hours and 56 minutes.
Many people report that social media negatively impacts their happiness.
Day one update, my screen time's 3 hours and 59 minutes, and I was super bored and not productive yesterday.
One update is 6 hours and 37 minutes. I really don't know how this happened. I'm feeling lost without my social media, but I've been playing Hungry Shark a lot.
2 hours and 28 minutes. I'm feeling great.
Day three update, 3 hours and 2 minutes.
We made it, and yesterday was amazing.
My day three update is 3 hours and 31 minutes. My lowest screen time yet.
Mine was now 45.
Oh, Red Bull by Charles Gambino.
No, look at Snapchat.
Oh, our detox is over.
After our social media detox, Miller felt he was more productive and he got a better night's sleep.
Abby said her experience was fine. She wouldn't do it again, but she recommends it.
Delaney got her homework done faster and she spent more time with her family.
Overall, we saw a decrease in screen time and we recommend that everyone tries this challenge.
That's seriously impressive.
I'd do anything to avoid a phone detox.
What about eating hot wings?
Honestly, even that.
Quinn and Miss Russell must have felt the same way.
I guess so. Let's hear the spicy questions they had to ask each other.
I'm Quinn McCormack and we're doing the hot wings challenges with
Miss Russell.
All right, let's get into it. First wing, first question.
Where were you when you found out you made the top 100?
I think I was in my room and my dad texted me and I found out. I was very excited. All right, second wing, second question.
How has the new head coach, Davis, helped you and your team succeed this year?
He's very nice, he's very honest with us, he's brutally honest. And he's really up my fashion with all the beanies that he wears to practice, gives me some good ideas to wear beanies. Korean barbecue.
Is that what it is, are we sure? And these are gonna get progressively hotter.
Oh yeah, oh this is a little spicy. All right, third sauce, third question.
Quinn, question number three. One of your teammates, Isaiah, said Quinn is growing as a leader as he takes on his role this season.
Well, that's awesome to hear. I really love Isaiah as a person. He's a great guy. And yeah, I think I have stepped into more of a leadership role. And I just like to shout out Isaiah and his outfit, game day choices. The beanies, I'm loving it. Sometimes he matches the beanies with the socks. Get me started on the powder puff. Miss Lucha's performance with the matching scarf and the matching hoodie.
You really did enjoy that.
And the matching beanie.
It was witness.
It was truly something for the ages. All right, question four, sauce four.
How do you prepare yourself for a game?
Wow.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. All right, diving in.
Game day tradition is usually I get a Billy Ray for, wow, it's pretty spicy. I'm at the Scotty's office, chit-chat, get taped. It's more chit-chat than tape, I'd say. But I'm still getting taped at the end of the day. Yeah, sauce five, question five.
Who do you think is the underclassman to watch out for and why?
Classman to look out for? I'd for sure have to go with Jordan Bennett. I mean, he got a bang out last game. Shout out Jordan Bennett. That's a dunk. Also another slang term.
Thank you for...
Yeah, no problem. Challenge is over after one cup of milk, one cup of chocolate milk, 3 cups of water. some blue cheese, a lot of napkins.
I didn't have any water yet.
I'd have to go with my favorite sauce as the Tango Mango Dango. What would you say your favorite sauce was?
I think I liked the buffalo the most out of everything.
Buffalo was great. Yeah, thank you for doing this.
Yeah, thank you for having me. This was a great lunch.
It was great. Yeah, it was great.
Okay. Head to WHB News to see the full video.
Oh, it's horrible. It's horrible.
I could never do what they just did. Honestly, mild has even been too spicy for me. Some things never change. Remember in middle school?
Let's not bring up those days.
Honestly, I miss how life felt so much simpler in middle school.
It's crazy how it's already been 4 years.
Before we roll the credits, Lauren, Sydney, Caroline, and Noah found out some of WHB's favorite memories.
Have a fun
and safe
weekend, WHB. I'm at a payphone
trying to call. My one favorite memory is the year that we played a Jeopardy game. And during, who was it? No, it was Noah. And Noah, you want a demo? Okay. And he broke my bell. The kids all pitched in money to buy me this new bell.
Okay, in my earth science class, my teacher used to say K after every single sentence. So me and my table started a list, and then one day she found it, and then she wanted us to continue keeping the list so she can correct herself.
I'd have to go with my favorite middle school memory is asking out Isabella Blanco and then breaking up with her like 2 weeks later in front of everyone. She was really sad.
He did jump out of the window once, out of the screen, when he was called down to the office, maybe, because there was a body size hole in my screen.
On our Frost Valley field trip in seventh grade in my cabin, we were sleeping and then all of a sudden we heard a laugh and we all started freaking out thinking it was a ghost. It was just the funniest thing ever.
One time, Katie O'Connor brought in a rotisserie chicken at 8:30 in the morning. I'll never forget that.
So we would always get yelled at for putting gum on the desk. So in the girls' locker room, we made a gum wall and a gum ceiling, and they never really found it because nobody looked up.
Oh, this one's rough. I went for the backboard. I don't know why I went back.
Yeah, same.
It's abusive. It's abusively spicy.
Yeah, this is rough.